Okay, a grade 12 applied workbook, movie, Mr. F. Geez, another one, part two. I must have been really bored this weekend. Okay, and I just copy these questions from the Manitoba Distance Learning website, the Merlin Blackboard. I showed you many times where that is. It's for non-commercial purposes only. All right. Read. So read this. All right, so I hope you understand we're just going in this one, we're just going to graph and solve using the computer. We're just going to, in applied math, it really isn't it's not necessary to fully understand what a logarithm is. All you got to do is know what buttons to press on a computer. That's pretty much what applied math is about. If you go get a job at Standard Aero or any manufacturing company or something, guess what? You don't actually do the welding. You don't actually do the drilling. It's a robot that does it. You actually touch a keypad and you tell the robot what to do. That's how it works these days. All right. So you gotta know if you're gonna do any like technology oriented manufacturing, you got to know how to do this type of stuff. All right. So this is the basic idea behind applied math. You press buttons thousands of times a day on your iPhone or your smartphone, and you don't really understand what it's doing, but you know it gives you what you want. So that's the idea behind applied math. If you want to understand what's really going on, then you'd probably want to do pre-cal. But you do press buttons thousands of times a day, and you have no idea how it really works, but you know that you get the answer you want. So there's nothing surprising about applied math. Okay, so we'll only do two here. Maybe I'll pull up the calculator for one of them. You know what? It's pretty much the same steps over and over. You're going to make a list. List one. You're going to make a list. List two. You're going to then plot the dots. Then you're going to calculate the regression equation. You're going to paste it into your Y equals graphing editor. Then you're going to hit graph. Then you're going to play around with the friggin' window until everything fits. And then you're going to find the value of the function for any particular x, and then you'll find the value of the y, a correction, then you'll find the value of the x for any particular y. It's the same things over and over and over, whether it's a line or a quadratic or a exponential or what have you. It's the same stuff over and over, so we can actually accelerate through all of this. All right, so read and do. Are you there? So I hope you know that when you join Facebook or Twitter or whatever else is out there, I don't do all that crap. It turns out that, you know, in the first few days, you get lots of friends, right? There's your total of friends. And then as the days go on, yeah, you're still getting more friends, but they start to tail off after a while, right? Notice in these 5 days, you picked up 9 friends. But in these 10 days, you only picked up 6 friends. It's a sort of like 3 and 5. So it turns out that your number of friends starts to tail off. You don't end up with an infinite number of friends. So let's find the logarithmic regression. And what a logarithm is, you don't really care. And you probably don't. You're just going to do what the calculator says. But here, I really do encourage you to sketch things on the back of a cigarette pack. I am not kidding you. You can probably figure out every problem in the universe by just drawing it on the back of a cigarette pack. Now, I'm not encouraging smoking, but of course, you can actually kind of do this on a little scrap of paper and get a pretty good idea of what the answer is. Watch this. Please consider doing things just like a real quick sketch to get an idea of what's going on. Please. All right, I'm going to put days along here. I'm going to do my own graph in my head. Well, no, I'm going to do it on a little scrap of paper. Honest to goodness, more than half of this city was built based on calculations on the back of a cigarette pack. I am not kidding you. All right, so I'm going to arrange it so I got like 30 days there. You know, I just gave it a little extra. And yeah, as long as you mark it off about right, I mean, that's not perfect, close enough, right? And then I said, well, you know what, I'm going to look at 40 is there, and so halfway it'd be 20, and halfway it'd be 10. So just make your own little grid, for God's sake. Can you do that? Just make it a nice linear grid there like that. And then you plot the dots. Can you see how I'm plotting the dots? Right, this is day 4. Look, there's day 5. So day 4 is about there. Gets you, what's that, day 19. There, close enough. You can actually solve a lot of things on the back of a cigarette pack like this. I am not kidding you. Day 9, you get 28 friends. By day 15, here's 15, you'd have 35 friends. Yeah, and then they say day 25, there's day 25. You're going to have 41 friends. There you go. Look at that. You didn't need a fancy computer to show you the pattern. You could have done this on the back of a cigarette pack, so to speak. This is called using your noggin. If you understand what we've done here, then you understand graphing and equations and everything implicitly. You don't need a fancy computer to do this stuff. So I think you realize that you get lots of friends the first few days. Right, look how the slope here is really steep. If you remember from grade 10, in grade 10 we learned about slope. A slope is a rate of change. Notice how the rate at which you collect friends is really steep here. You know, every day you get a lot of friends. And then later on, as time goes by, notice how this starts to level off. It never does level off, but it takes a lot longer to get another friend. So that's kind of the idea. Notice this thing never does level off. It might take another 2 years for you to get another 6 friends, but it never does actually level off. It never does go asymptotic, so to speak. All right, so anyway, I just want you to please appreciate you can actually do a lot of this stuff just by hand, just sketching it. Think about it, please. Okay, let's try some more here. Now we'll get more elegant and we'll actually use a computer, even though we didn't have computers 50 years ago. All right, so you're going to enter this data into your list, the old stat edit, and then you're going to go clear, enter, clear up the list, type in the numbers. Oh my goodness, how many times have we done this? And then you're going to select a function, and the function we're doing is the ln function, the logarithm. All right. I know there's no n in logarithm, but this is the function you use. Don't get confused with the logistic function. That is something different. I'll explain that to you. So don't think that this is the log function. The one we want for a logarithmic is this one. This is a special logarithm. It's called the natural logarithm. Anyway, you want this one. Don't screw with this one. So you want to select that, and the way you select that is you go stat, and then you drift right to the calc, and then you select number 9, regression. You'll hear teachers call it the lawn regression, lawn, like in your front yard, your lawn. So it'll be called the lawn regression, or you could call it the logarithmic regression. Don't confuse it with the logistic regression. You will never see that. We won't be using that one, I don't think. So we want the logarithm, the logarithmic, the lawn regression. And when you do all that, it tells you this fancy formula. There you go. If I round it off a little bit, it says that the y is equal to 1.99 plus 12.09 times the lawn, the logarithm of x. And you're going, what the heck is a logarithm? Don't worry about it. Just do what the computer tells you. You don't need to understand. If you want to understand it later, well, then we can do that. I'll try to teach it to you, but you got to be able to think backwards. So some people are good at that. Just do what the computer says. There's the form. It's the same steps as we've always done. All right, so we found the regression equation. The plastic brain told us that. You wouldn't be able to do that in your... you could maybe do that in your head if you knew what you're doing. All right, so now we hit the dot plot, and we plot it. Now, this was a trick question. The question was, how many friends will you have after 2 months? Well, you got to be careful because your data was in days. I don't know if they did this on purpose, but it's a trick question. So I'm going to assume that 2 months is 60 days. There are some months that have 31 days in them. So sometimes you got to just assume what the teacher meant. And then, of course, once you've got the equation, you've already calculated the equation on the previous calculations there. Well, it gives you the table. Once you just look in the table, you could cycle down through the table, and at day 60, you're going to have 51.51 friends. So there's one way to do it. Or you could ask the spider, right? If you expand your window off to the right a little bit. So you'd have to monkey around with the window so you can see where you want to be. And if you ask the spider by going second trace number one value, then you say, tell me what I will have after 60. And the spider goes bing and says, well, here's 60 days and here's your friends. Or you could plug in manually. Didn't we say this was the equation to calculate how many friends you have? So all you do is, if your x is 60, you could just type it in like that on any calculator. And it would tell you the answer. Once you know this equation, that's why you calculate this. This will tell you the y for any or some value of x. So if I tell you the value of x I'm interested in is 60, you just plug it into the equation and boom. Now that's an LN. That's the LN button on your calculator. How long will it take the user to earn 65 friends? Well, that's where you go. Second trace. How many times have we done this? Second trace number 5. So you got to type in a nice constant 65, and you got to diddle with the window. You got to diddle with the window so you can see where they cross. That's the hardest part about the computer, is playing with the window. Just, you'll get used to it after you do like 100 of these. So the plastic brain will tell you after you do second trace number 5, boom, 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 that after 183 days, you're going to have 65 friends. So notice the LN graph never does level off. No logarithm graph actually levels off. So it never does go asymptotic. It never does reach like a level and then just closer and closer. It does continually climb forever. It just slows down so slowly. It slows down and, it never does actually level off. So don't think that this thing actually levels off. It just takes a heck of a long time to get one more friend once you've already got everybody on the planet. All right, so here, let me do all of those on the plastic brain then. This will be the last time I do this. So let's type in our guys here. Find the logarithmic regression. Here we go. Are you ready? Turn on my calculator. I said you go stat. Edit. And, I got to clear out the list here. That's another problem. So I go to the top, clear, enter. I go to the top of the list, clear, enter. All right, so now my lists are empty. My list 1 and my list 2. This will be my list 1. This will be my list 2. List 1, list 2. Boom. And I'm going to type them in. Here, I'll pause for you there so I don't bore you. 35. Make sure your lists are the same length. If they're not the same length, you'll get an error called a dimension error. Let's see, 1 gets me 2, 4, 19, 9, 20, 8, 15. Okay, so I got all that typed in there. And we want the equation. So how did I calculate the equation? Well, I'm going to go stat, calculate. And this time I want a Not a logistics equation, not that. That's different. We want the ln, the ln regression. All right, so I'm going to select enter. And notice it pastes it on a line on my main screen all by itself. And you know what? While I'm at it, I'm going to do the old vars, y vars, function y1. And you know why I do that. That way, when it calculates the equation, it'll paste it into the y equals equation editor. So I hit enter. Look, it's flashing. It wants me to do something. Enter. Hey, it tells me the answer. Look, there's the equation. And notice from the 0.9999s that it's a pretty good fit. So you know you can rely on this. It's a pretty good calculation. It seems to fit all the dots really, really nicely. All right, so there's how I got that. And then, of course, then I graph it. So the best way to graph is go hit graph. And, of course, it's still set up from the last time I did something there. So I want to go, let me clear out all the crap that I, oh, let me clear up. So there's the equation that we calculated. I pasted it in, but let me get rid of this one from the previous time. And I hit graph. And, of course, you know what? I want to see my dots. So that's zoom number 9. Zoom number 9 will make everything fit just perfectly. Oh, no. Where did my dots go? Oh, you know what? Check this out. I always do this. Look, I forgot to turn on my dots. Look, my dots were turned off. So I got to tell it to turn on the dot paper in the background. So I cursor over to the on, and I press enter. Now my dots are turned on. Now I can hit graph. Now when I go zoom number 9, all the dots will be perfectly spaced on my screen. Isn't that, look, looks just like that, funny enough. And then the question was, how many friends will I have after 2 months? So I assume that was 60 days, so a couple of ways to do that. You could just go second graph, which gives you the table. See where it says table in yellow? Table in yellow. So second graph gives you the table, and you can cursor through the table like that. And we wanted to know how many friends do you have after 60 days. Looks like 51.15 right there. Or you could ask the spider. Let's ask the spider. Go back to your graph. Get the spider to follow along the curve and tell you instead. Because sometimes, you know, the table only shows like whole counting numbers normally. So if you want to know some other types of numbers, the spider will find it too. So when we go graph. And so now the spider, we want 60. Right now we're only going 25 to the right now. See, that's dot 25. So let's see. Yeah, that's only going 25 to the right. We want to go 60 or more to the right. So we're going to have to monkey around with the window. Sorry about that. The second story window. So we want to go more to the right. We want to go to at least 60 to the right. So let's go 75. I always like to leave a little extra so I'm not right up against the wall. And I hit graph. Oh, that's a little bit better. So now the question is, did I do that right? Yeah, 75. So now the question is, so we'll get the spider to tell us where we are. And so we could try that. So now the problem, of course, well, here, let's get the spider. All right, here we go. Second trace skill, trace. So I'm going to get the spider to follow along there. So I'm going to go second trace. I'm going to find a value. And I'm going to say, where am I when I hit 60 days? So I'm going to get it to follow up and watch what happens. It goes, oh, there you are. And it's up there somewhere. You can't quite see it, can you? So let's open up the window a little bit more. So let's open up the window. So we're going to probably open this up a little bit more because it was scrunched right up the top. Let's make this like about 80 or something. All right, overshoot it by a bit. Ah, that's a nicer picture. All right, so now let's get the spider to do that again. Sorry, you got to monkey around with the window. There's no way around it. Zoom fit doesn't work all that well all the time. Second, trace. Find a value. Find the value when the x is 60. When I do that, boom, the spider jumps to the position and says, look, when your x is 60, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, your y is 51.51. Right there. All right. Or you could have just done a plain, you could have taken a Dollarama calculator and just typed it in because you already know the equation. You already know that it's 1.99. You already agree that this equation here tells you the y for any particular x. So you just go 1.99 plus 12.09 times the logarithm of 60. And even a dollarama calculator will tell you this. Boom, 51.49. Now, it's not exactly the same as that calculation because, guess what? I rounded these off a bit, didn't I? It wasn't really 1.99. It was really 1.99494474295, etc. So anytime you start using a rounded number, don't expect to get the exact same answer. Anyway, that's kind of the fun you have with that. How about the next slide there? And then we said, so when do you get to 65 friends? That's the question. All right, so you go back to your graph, and you go, well, let's see, I'm going up, up, up. Right, I'm going up, up, up. I get to 28 friends, 35 friends, 41 friends, 65 is, well, let's have a look. Let's do a line at 65, a horizontal line at 65. Let's see if that's going to show on the graph. Are you ready? Oh, yeah, it shows, but look, they cross way over here to the right. Oh, man, you got to mess around with the window again. So you got to go, and you know that you got to go to the right a lot more. Right now, you're quitting at 75, so let's go to the right. Now, let's just give her 200. Let's give it 200. So let's open up the window so it goes 200 to the right. Hey, look. I can actually see where they kind of cross right there. So you could zoom in on that if you know how to zoom. But you know what? I think the calculator will find that. I think the spider will find. Let's try it. Let's see if the spider comes up with an answer. Second, trace. We want to find where they intersect, number 5. Or just press the button 5. And the spider says, okay, 2 curves. Which one? That one? And you go, yep. It says, and this one? And you go, yep. Well, you only had 2 typed in there. Do you want to give it a guess? Yeah, there. It's somewhere over here. You give her. And it says the answer is 182.97, so pretty much 183 days until you get to 65 friends. There you go. So that was pretty easy. It's the same crap over and over again. Notice the ln, the LN, the natural logarithm graph, never does go asymptotic, all right? It never does level off. You will always get another friend. It might take 6 months to get one more friend, but you will always, always get another friend. It doesn't level off. It just is so slowly growing that you don't really notice. All right, so there's a perfect example of a logarithm. All right, let's try a bowling alley here. All right, read and do. All right, pause it if you have to. Read, do. All right, so the same old stuff, right? So I encourage you to think. Think. Before you start smashing stuff into a calculator, sit on your hands. Put away the calculator. Sit on your hands and just think about bowling for a second. Have you ever noticed that the more you bowl, the better your score gets? So you improve every game. But of course, you don't improve to an infinite score, do you? Eventually you start to level off. I didn't say you do level off. Eventually you start to level off in your skill level. I mean, you still might gain a little extra, but it might take you 10 games to gain a little extra skill, whereas when you first start, you can gain lots of skill very quickly. So it's all got to do with the rate at which you learn your skills, kind of like learning. So why don't you just do a sketch? You know how your learning works. You know how your skill at bowling or anything works. You can do it on the back of a cigarette pack like this. This is how half of the city was built, on the back of a cigarette pack. I am not joking. Any engineer would tell you this. So I'm just going to do it in like that. There, that's a pretty rudimentary but very effective graph. Notice I tried to space things just perfectly. Watch. I can see the graph right now. A 2 gets me a 125. So seriously, I know you don't believe me, and I know I gotta say this every time, but you can solve pretty accurately, or fairly estimatively, a lot of stuff just by sketching it on a little scrap of paper. This is how we built cities for hundreds of years before we had calculators. All right, so there's the first few points there. So after 5 games, you got a score of 155. After 9 games, you've got a score of 175. After 25 games, you've got a score of 215. And after 40 games, you just a couple more points. Notice how you're really learning at first. So the rate at which you're learning is kind of, it's called the slope. A slope is how quickly things change. Have you ever noticed that? A slope on a toboggan hill. Things change quickly when you got a steep slope, don't they? So we studied slope in grade 10 essential. Maybe you remember that slope is just a rate of change. Notice you have a big rate of change at first in your skill level, and then later on you're still having a rate of change. You're still improving, just not as quickly. There you go. If you understand this picture, then you understand logarithms. Now we can just get fancy with all the numbers. I hate numbers. There's way too many of them. And, of course, here's what you do. It's the same thing. Oh, I'm not going to do this one again. All right, you can just... So you do the list. So here's what we're trying to do here. The bowling alley says, oh, if you come and you play 15 games, then you'll have a score of 200. So they're trying to sell you some lessons. And so they're saying, well, you know that 9 games get you 175 and 25 games gets you kind of like 215. So when do you get to 200 so you can brag to your boyfriend? So the question is, how many games would go with a 200? That's what we're trying to figure. It's called solving, when you got to figure out what gives you a certain amount. So you can kind of see where the answer kind of is. It's somewhere between 9 and 25. And, of course, the bowling alley claims that's a 15. Really? Do you think so? I don't know. Let's get the plastic brain to see if they're fibbing to us. So you would plot the dots, right? You know how to do that, I hope. And you would calculate the regression equation, right? And then once you get the regression equation, you can calculate the score for some value of x. It doesn't matter what. And then you plug it in and you go, so, when do I get to a score of 200? And when do you get to a score of 200? Plastic brain tells you 17.18 games. Ah, so the bowling alley was lying. It's going to take you more than 15 games to break 200. Well, they weren't lying. Maybe you're just a crappy bowler. That could be it too, because all of these are like statistical. So maybe you're just a crappy bowler. That's why these are done on the statistics button, because a lot of these things are statistical in nature. Well, there you go. So I didn't show you how to do that on this beast, because you know what? It's the same steps over and over and over. If you've done lines, and you've done quadratics, and you've done cubics, and you've done exponential functions, then it's the same steps over and over. You put in the list, you plot the dots, you calculate the equation, and you find your answers. Boom. It's the same thing over and over. So now I was just thinking, was this log a good model for the bowling? Maybe you know that in 10-pin bowling, the very, very best perfect score is 450. If you get a strike like 3 times in a row for all 10 ends, so that if you get 30 strikes, you can actually get a perfect 450. So technically, the logarithm model continues forever upward. Well, if you can't get above 450, then the logarithm model must peter out. So the logarithm model dies once you get to perfect score. So sometimes your mathematical models are only useful in a certain domain, all right? So or a certain range. After some point, they're going to die out. But hey, a model's a really good tool to calculate things as long as you're aware of its limitations. So be careful. We often use the word log and lawn. So log and lawn, we actually use them interchangeably. That means sometimes we just carelessly fling them around like they're the same thing. Well, technically they are the same basic idea. So just be careful. Don't get confused by log and lawn. They're pretty much interchangeable basic ideas. So out of interest then, I said, so I wonder how long it would take to get a perfect game. So I wanted to calculate when do you get to 450. So I actually had to monkey around with the window. And even by taking the window 10,000 games off to the right, I still never got to 450. Oh my goodness. So even though I went 10,000 games off to the right, I still never did get to a value of 450. So then I used some proper algebra. If you want to know how to use proper algebra to solve these, I calculated that it would take 19,387 games or so to get a score of 450. And then, so I said, well, how many years would that take you? So I said, well, let's see. I like doing this stuff, right? So I said, if you play 3 games a night, every night, Sunday nights too, for 18 years, that would be 19,387 games or so. So it would probably take you 18 years of bowling every night until you got the perfect score. Well, that's the theory. That's what the model says. Maybe you're a really good bowler and you do it on the third night. Or maybe you're extra lucky, right? Because luck and statistics and probability and all, they're all kind of combined. Anyway, that's the fun stuff there. I shouldn't show you this. Pretend you didn't see this. Hang out with me at lunch if you want to know more on this stuff. So there's a review. The log function is just another function. It's no different than the lines and the quadratics and the parabolas, that is, and the cubics, the things with two wiggles, and the exponents, the things that grow forever upwards. It's just another relationship between some numbers, some x's and y's. It's no big deal to plot it. It's the same as we've been doing all along. It's no big deal to graph it, right? It's no big deal to plot the dots. It's no big deal to calculate and plot and graph the graph. It's no big deal to solve equations. Doesn't matter whether it's linear, quadratic, cubic, we've been doing the same steps over and over and over. Oh my goodness, you can actually solve anything now if you wanted. The more you learn, the easier learning gets. So check out my Logarithms Explained movie. I'll try to crank one of those off next just to explain what a little more in-depth what an exponential is. But I think we already agreed that you don't really need to understand what an exponent is in order to get an answer. You don't know what the buttons do on your iPhone or on your tablet, but you do know you get an answer. So, enjoy it.